Well, good day, good morning, or however when you watch this. My name's Drew, I'm your local disruptor. This is the Disruptor channel, and we're here to provide you a daily car vlog right now. So we post our daily car vlogs Monday through Friday, 5 a.m. The reason why we post them at 5 a.m. is so that you guys can watch this while you have your coffee. Yes, we do. So if you want to, you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, hit that notification, and subscribe to our channel for daily vlogs. All right, so on to today's blog topic. Now, for those of you who are new, we generally run these in with no post, meaning what you get is what you get, and it's done in one shot, one take. There's no edits. I don't even take out the ums and ahs. I just leave them in place. I'm not a professional, nor do I claim to be. I am just a routine guy. I'm just a regular YouTuber. I'm just a person who posts videos, talks about what I want to talk. You talk about comments, stuff like that. So feel free to post a comment, leave a comment, tell me I suck, tell me I should go pound sand, whatever. Good feedback, any feedback, let me know, and we'll go on from there. So on with today's topic. So today we're gonna talk about what's really hot this week, and that is the Floyd Mayweather and Conor McGregor fight tonight. Considered probably one of the craziest super fights out there. It has definitely been a showboat show. A lot of media presence, a lot of getting stuff done. So yeah, I'm just doing a fighter breakdown. So if you're looking for like video clips of people fucking, of the wonderful commentary, I'm a fucking polar bear, right? That kind of shit, or the fuck you suits. Yeah. Obviously, I think if you're Floyd Mayweather, if you're trying to get into somebody's skin, don't hide behind your security crew after you talk shit. You know, that just doesn't make any sense. That just makes you look short and weak. and it's passive aggressive. So, yeah, that was dumb. So let's go on with what we're talking about here. So let's go on with the fighter's breakdown here. And we're just going over fighter breakdown here as a boxer. I don't want to have the counter arguments about, oh, he would do this in MMA. We already know that if Floyd Mayweather had walked into an MMA ring with Conor McGregor, that's a hands down win. You wouldn't even see a betting line for Mayweather except for a miracle shot, because I don't think Floyd Mayweather will do anything worthwhile in the MMA field. I mean, he couldn't handle fake wrestling. So yeah, you got to look at what he's doing as a boxer, and that's what we're looking at here. So just keeping it a fair fight, essentially, in that demographics. And to Connor's statement, there's no such thing as a fair fight. You always want to put all these rules. You want to fight me, but you want to put rules on how you're going to fight me. You know, right? So leave it at that. All right. So we're going to go with punching power. Like, who has the better punching power? I honestly think that if you were to weigh out who had the better punching power, Conor McGregor has it. He has the better punching power. He has the better strike, better cleaner punch, straight off the chin, no wind up, no cock back, and the fact that he has something that no one has ever said about Mayweather. I misjudged his punching power by more than one of his competitors, right? And that's the biggest mistake is, plus he's a southpaw. So he's gonna force Mayweather to step into, ideally try to force Mayweather to step into his power range. I'm a lefty as well. I love that dynamic of unorthodox and southpaw boxing, because you're at a direct advantage. Someone like me who's really tall and lanky, and I'm a lefty, so it makes it for a lot more fun. So slip speed, who has the better ability to slip a punch? I would have to say that's gonna go to Mayweather. Mayweather will stand in front of you and make you feel like he's a hologram and your punches go through him, not at him or around him. So know that on that one. In Connor's case, he tends to slip and eat a punch, take a lot of glancing blows. That's not something you wanna do with a boxer. You can get away with it in MMA a little bit. But you can't get away with it in boxing as much. In that case, I would think Mayweather hasn't beat on that. Counter punching, that's an easy one. Although Conor McGregor is a great counter puncher, he's not built like Anderson Silva, who is a counter puncher, counter and striker. Likes to bait you in and then hit you and kick you with a front kick and leave you knocked out, forgetting where you were the last 3 days. So yeah, you have that. Then you have ring control. Like, who has better ring control and ring presence? Mayweather does. He just does it naturally. You just see the natural footwork, the natural movement. And this also goes to the fact I've never seen Conor McGregor actually fight a professional boxing match. Sparring is different. You do things differently in sparring. You don't work on, you don't do your full game in sparring. You work on one dimension and you attack it at full force until you get it right. Or in my case, until you can't get it wrong. So with the ring control, he definitely has that. Conor's good with ring control and body positioning, but that's only to be seen in MMA. And there's a lot better techniques in ring control in MMA. Like, you can pick your guy up, skirt him across the ring, you know, the mat, whatever you need to do to get there. So it goes to Mayweather. Now, for general mechanics as a fighter, like, who has the better mechanics, who's a cleaner fighter, who has, you know, the best technique? On that one, for mechanics, I hate, as much as I hate to say this, for the general mechanics, it's Mayweather. On the boxing scale, right? On the boxing scale. He's got very clean, methodical mechanics. He's, you know, his father's been training for years. He's got some of the best trainers in the world, you know, right? Some of long-term training, you know, out there kicking ass, taking names. It's nothing new to him. So you get those, you get that in the mechanics for Mayweather. It's obvious, you know. And in Conor, it's not so obvious. He's just not as clean as Mayweather is when it comes to the mechanics. And that also comes from the fact that, you know, when you do MMA, you adapt a fighting stance and a fighting style that allows you to remain open to the arsenal in which the person has available to them and against you. In the classic words of John Fain, you can learn to get good at one thing, or you have to learn to defend against everything, right? So, yeah. And now we're talking about engagement. Now this is what I like, okay? Who would be the better engagement? Who's gonna bring on more engagements in the fight, right? And that is real simple. It's gonna be Conor. Conor's gonna bring the biggest engagement because of the fact that Conor isn't afraid to get in there and just throw, right? You know, and I really think that if it goes late in the cards and Conor's behind on the cards, we're actually going to see someone who's consciously aware of where he sits at the end result of the fight, and it's just going to open up for the fucking fence. And he's just going to go for the kill, and he's just going to go for the squeaky win, and he's going to go and hopefully knock out Mayweather, where Mayweather's going to get into his critical point game, he's going to get defensive, he's going to get good, and he's not going to really engage at later in the rounds, especially if he gets the fight ahead of cards, you know. So we have that. Now, fight control. Like, but what I mean by fight control is being the ability a fighter has of imposing his fight plan against the other opponent. In the classic words of Muhammad Ali, we all have a plan until we get hit. And that's really true. It's the hard part as a fighter is sticking to your game plan after those hits, and sticking to it and not letting the match change what you're doing, sticking to what you're good at, not getting cocky. I learned that the hard way. I was pretty much dominating one of my fights in MMA, and I know that my ground game sucks, but instead of doing what I knew I should have done and pushed off and kept it standing, I got cocky because I was owning the stand-up. I decided to try to go for a guillotine and then turn it into a triangle choke once I got mounted. And yeah, long story short, my cockiness and my falling into trying to work around his plan and what he was doing to me, and he was, you know, Josh's case, he imposed his will on me and it worked. He won. He changed the game, he changed the levels, and he imposed his will and he won. And in that case, for Mayweather, he does that to everybody. Come on, he did it to Carmelo, he did it to Pacquiao, shit, he did it to fucking De La Hoya, you know. does it to everybody, and he's good at it. He is good at imposing his will in a fight. Connor, sadly, not so much. Nate Diaz proved that he can get in someone's head and get you to throw excessively, make mistakes, do that. And in Connor's case, he cannot do that against someone like Mayweather. Mayweather will capitalize the fuck on that if you don't get to get your game on, or he gets inside your head and gets you to throw more than you need to, or to do more than you want to. He's won. And that's evident in the first 4 or 5 rounds of boxing when it comes to any match, when you deal with people who win matches by simply imposing their will onto their opponent. Mayweather does that very well, right? He takes out their number one game. So then you have, so with that, we kind of went over things. So we went over punching power, slip speed, counter punching, ring control, mechanics, engagement, fight control. Who do I think will win? On paper, it's gonna be Mayweather, right? But who am I putting my betting money on? Connor. And there's twofold for that. Do I think Connor can beat Mayweather? I think so. Is it gonna be hands down decisive? No. What are the concerns in the fight? I'm really concerned that, you know, Connor will throw one big freaking tie kick into Mayweather's head in frustration, and long story short, Mayweather will go down because of it, but the fight will be disqualified for an illegal blow, and it may lead into them going into an MMA bout, but I don't really think that'll happen, because Mayweather, you'll get the shit knocked out of you, dude, in an MMA bout. Your smartest move was making it a boxing match, right? But if in fact, you know, like I said, the main reason too for betting is it's just, you have to be stupid to bet, to put money on Mayweather win, because you have to put a ton of money to make money, versus you could put short money on Connor, and if he wins, you win big, right? And I think he's got a fairly good stance at winning. I mean, obviously they couldn't sell this fight if you didn't think he was gonna win, you know, right? And that's the thing, is it's a great way of selling a fight, great showmanship, great way to, you know, bring people around, because a lot of people are like, yeah, whatever, and you know, I didn't even think it was gonna happen, and now it's actually happening, and it's gonna happen this weekend. I won't be watching it because I'm going to Kenny Chesney on at the same time, and I'd rather go do that. So, yeah. Plus, the Manny Pacquiao fight, not to Mayweather's performance, but to Pacquiao's performance, made me say that I am never paying more than $60 for a pay-per-view event ever again, unless it's a multi-championship fight on UFC, right? Or a Night of Champions. I mean, UFC, you gotta bring back Night of Champions. Come on. When are you guys gonna bring that back, where you have a whole entire pay-per-view that everything on the main card is a title defense? Right? When are you gonna bring those matches back? When are you gonna bring those type of pay-per-view back? You know, that's back when the heyday, when almost every pay-per-view had a major title or titles on the line. Now we're getting a title, or prelims, or no defenses, or the winner of this match in the main event gets a title shot at the next major pay-per-view, you know. And that's generally my thought process on that, with when it comes to, you know, Mayweather and processing fights and whatnot. So now that I've begun to ramble, and I am nowhere near where I need to be because of my insatiable rambling, real quick rundown: punching power, Connor; slip speed, Mayweather; counter punching, Mayweather; ring control, Mayweather; mechanics, Mayweather; engagement, Connor; fight control, Mayweather. Who do I think is gonna win the fight? Mayweather. Who am I going to bet on to win the fight? Connor, right? And the only really decisive thing is, what's really going to change the game plan is really how Connor goes into this fight. If he goes in and he blows his wad in the first 5 rounds, he's SOL, right? But if he goes in there and he does what Connor does best, he's gonna win. And that's the fun thing about this fight. If both fighters do what they do best, right, it's gonna be a good fight and it'll happen. But you know, Mayweather is really good at ensuring that his opponents don't have their best fight, that they don't perform their best during the fight, that they don't do what they want to do during their fight. So yeah, you know, we'll see it there. Let me know, put a comment below. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, hit the little notification bell whistle if you want. Leave us a comment. We do reply to all of them. Sorry about that. And so before I let you go, work hard, be nice.